Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God and these witnesses to celebrate the joyous love of Edward Odell Hall and Cheryl Ann Springer and support them in their decision to be joined in the bonds of holy matrimony. Marriage should never be entered into without great reverence, and so I now ask Edward and Cheryl, have you come here of your own free will and without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage? If there is anyone who knows any just cause why these two should not be joined in matrimony, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. And who gives this bride to be married?
Her mother and I.
Ephesians 5 tells us that both halves of a couple have their role to play to make for a successful whole marriage that will work. To Cheryl, I would point out the verses 22 through 24. This says, wives, submit yourselves unto your husband as you would unto the Lord. For the husband is the lead of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let wives be so to their husbands in everything. Do you accept Edward on these terms, to have and to hold, for richer for poor, in sicknesses and health, from this day forward? To Edward, I would point out the verses 22 through 29, which instructs husbands to love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present unto himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loves his wife loves himself, for no man has yet hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord loves the church. Edward, do you accept Cheryl on these terms, to have and to hold, for richer for poor, in sickness as in health, from this day forward?
I do.
To you both, I would add verse 31, which says, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, that they too shall become one flesh. Okay? Edward, the ring for the bride? Edward, if you will place the ring on her finger and repeat after me. I, Edward, give you Cheryl.
I, Edward, give you Cheryl.
This ring as a symbol.
This ring as a symbol.
Of my lasting love and devotion.
My lasting love and devotion.
No matter what may come our way.
No matter what may come our way.
Okay. Cheryl, if you will place the ring on his finger and repeat after me. I, Cheryl, give you Edward.
I, Cheryl, give you Edward.
This ring as a symbol.
This ring as a symbol.
Of my lasting love and devotion.
Of my lasting love and devotion.
No matter what may come our way.
No matter what may come our way.
Remember always the wisdom of 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8. That tells us that love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, and it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love never fails. Now as this couple, individual lights unite into a single flame, I am proud to say that with the power vested in me by the state of Michigan and our Lord God, that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Son, you may kiss your beautiful bride. Now, it is my best honor to introduce formally for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Edward Hall and son.
There.